Hello everybody, welcome to Cape Rugby TV. It's Wednesday night and we bring you the very best of what's happening in the world of Western Province Club Rugby. Tonight's show is a little bit different and we'll be looking at the top eight finals that was held at City Park over the weekend. It's of course the President's Cup that's happening at Newlands this coming weekend, and it was the launch of the Western Province Club Rugby Sevens last night at Tohosan in Newlands. So tonight there are no panel members with me because we've got a jam-packed show full of content and rugby action, and so we don't need any additional guests. We're just quite simply going to go into all of your favorite rugby content. Also coming up a little bit later in the show, we'll of course bring you the insert from Best Med, of course come on board with the Western Province Rugby School of Excellence. A big thanks to Hisense that has come on board with Cape Rugby TV as the official technical partner. And don't forget, you can win yourself a case of Score Energy drinks. That comes up later in the show, so keep your cell phones handy and you can win yourself a case of Score Energy drinks. Big thanks also to Factory Shops SA Mobile App. They've come aboard with Cape Rugby TV. And if you want to win yourself but you want to download that app to get yourself to the nearest factory shop to you. All right, folks, let's start right in the beginning. We'll start off with Super League C this time around. We'll do it a little bit in reverse, considering that was the sequence of the games that were played over at City Park on the weekend in the top eight, or at least the bottom eight, of Super League A, B, and C. So in Super League C, the first game up was Strand United against Wraithby. We managed to check out the first half. Let's see what happened. Things are pretty tight there between Strand United and Wraithby in the first half. It was, of course, your typical derby match. Let's check out the second half and we'll give you the results in a sec. Typical derby match there between Strand United and Wraithby, and it's pretty much what one would have expected. Running rugby between the guys, but it was a win for Wraithby then, 24-21, and well, they'll be happy with that, you know, derby match out of the Helderberg region, And Wraithby's certainly been showing some running rugby, considering the fact that they also hosted the Sevens earlier on in the year. Also, in fact, presented by Score. We managed to catch up with Wraithby coach Shahid Barnes.
Ja, ek sê die game was baie hard. As ons Strand United speel, is altyd hard. Is 'n local derby. En so ek weet die guys gesê het gestaan by ons team talk dat as ons dit wil deurdruk, sal ons alles moet op die spel sit. En dis wat die guys vandag gedoen het. Ja, dit is 'n ons het nie so 'n goeie seisoen gehad nie, maar wat ons gestaan was gesê het by ons span, ons team talk is die feit dat die wen gee vir ons 'n goeie boost vir volgende seisoen. Dis hoekom ons sê dit is nie ons laaste game van die seisoen nie, maar wel ons eerste game van die volgende seisoen.
Nice positive attitude there from Wraithby coach Shahid Barnes, and interesting perspective to be looking at the almost like it's their first game of the new season, and they'll be using this victory to use as a building block for next year. Of course, Shahid and his Wraithby counterparts were at the Western Province Rugby Sevens launch last night, and the guys are very excited about getting into the Sevens. But there was a man of the match who was a star performer in the win against Strand United, Clint Stewart.
I want to first say baie dankie vir die man van Bo. Dit is so lekker gegaan die jaar saam met Osie, maar well done out vandag die knop deurgehak. En om min of de meeste is op zo'n grote dag ons ooit langlijks in de final gespeeld, voel ik bij je trots. En ik wil net bij je danken aan mijn team is dat ik die boel kan uitkomen met om min of de meeste is. Tava game was altijd Tava United bij je nabij ons. Ons kennen elkaar, ons het vastgevallen in de eerste ronde van die liga. Maar ons werd weer geweest vandaag, hij was een vloek geweest, zo vandaag het ons boel uitgekomen. Zo wel dan aan mijn boys.
A very happy man of the match there, Clint Stewart. And of course, Tarek van der Ross is the coach at Strand United. And you would remember that we went out there not so long ago and once again doing a sterling job. And you can see it by the results. Close game then, Wraithby against Strand United. Let's catch up now with Tarek van der Ross, coach at Strand United.
Yeah, we had a busy long week. The guys were training hard, excited for the final. It's been a long, long season. So, it took a lot of hard work to get the guys together again. And in the end, we couldn't pull it through. Yeah, Derby, Helderberg Derby is always a tough game. We beat them in the first game of the season. So I'm sure they wanted to get some revenge. And they managed to do it. Close score. So, congratulations to them.
Tarek van der Ross there, coach at Strand United. A little bit disappointed, but nevertheless, always keeping his chin up. Right, folks, if you want to win yourself a case of Score Energy drinks, then all you need to do is grab your mobile phone, SMS the word SCORE to 33280. SCORE to 33280, and you can put yourself in the mix to win a case of Score Energy drinks. Congratulations to last week's winner, Anastasia Kluter. Anastasia, somebody from Cape Rugby TV will be in touch with you shortly, and you win yourself a case of 24 Score Energy drinks. We'll be taking an ad break, folks, and when we come back, we'll catch up with the top eights from City Park, and this time we'll be looking at the results in Super League B. Back in a sec. Welcome back, folks. It's Cape Rugby TV Wednesday night. We always bring you what's happening in the world of Western Province Club Rugby. All right, as you know, we're looking at the various fixtures from the from City Park this evening, as well as the launch of the West Roms Club Rugby Sevens. That comes up a little bit later in the show. Don't forget that insert from Best Med, who's of course on board with the Western Province Rugby School of Excellence. Well, it was the Super League B Top 8 final between Hands and Hearts and Young Peoples. Hands and Hearts, of course, took it to them, but it wasn't close enough. Let's catch up with the first half highlights in the match, Hands and Hearts against Young Peoples. We'll be right back. fans and arts and young peoples tagging into each other there, of course, at City Park. Let's check out the second half highlights now. For young people's hands and hearts taking into the guys with a win there, 36-24 for hands and at least young people's over hands and hearts. We spoke to some of the guys from hands and hearts, bitterly disappointed. Of course, Alistair Frazenberg was, of course, at the Western Province Sevens launch last night as well. You can probably see him in the launch video. But let's talk now to the young people's coach, Brent Martens.
Ons gees was baie op. Want ons wil bewys dat ons die presidentsbeker wil vat en ons die top bottom uit ernstig opgevat het. En ons seisoen was nie so goed nie, maar ons het die laaste van die paar games van die seisoen het ons goed gespeel en ons wil afeindig met 'n goeie noot. Dis hoekom ons gees baie goed was. Baie tough team, hulle speel die meer dieselfde wat ons speel, harde rugby. En hulle wil alles speel en dit was 'n tough team, maar my manne daarom gehou vandag.
Young people's coach Brent Martin talking to us there, and now let's catch up with the young people's coach, at least their captain, Ricardo De Bruyne.
It was a hard game, but the game was in a good geest. Because the man from Pouche was very thankful, but it was not an ernstig passieren. The geest was this week very good. The man was there for the football was there. He had a total opgekomen, what he had seen gebeuren. Die laatste paar games lijkt niet dat die mannen zijn focus hier daar geweest en dat is goede voorbereiding weer die geweest. En dat is wat die appels geplukken hebben bij deze dagse game. We gaan een beetje celebreren naar die win. Ons is zoals jouw doel wat gezet voor die laatste drie games, zoals wel die win. Want we gaan een goede season afgesleten. En ons moet het vandaag celebreren, maar man heeft nog rust. Maar als nog 7 uur afkomt, er is nog een paar mannen wat op je vond zijn nooit dan geweest.
Very happy young people's captain Ricardo De Bruyne talking to us there. Let's catch up now with the losing captain and coach. Never nice to talk about the losing captain and coach, but it's the only way to introduce the guys. We of course now talk to Peter Links. He's been coach at the Hands and Hearts for a while now, come to the end of the season, but I'm sure they'll be looking forward to the Sevens. But at the Sevens, of course, the management and coaches do seem to mix it up a little bit. And so speak to Hands and Hearts coach now, Peter Links.
Ek dink nie ons het opgedaag vandag nie. People het gewys, hulle was duidelik honger as ons. Ek het die ou boys gesê, as ons hier gaan werk aan ons first time tackles hier, dan het ons vandag gewys. Hulle gesê, dan gaan ons die game kos en dat het praktisch wat so uitgewerk. Te veel tackles gemis, first time tackles, en people het dit explore. En geluk aan hulle, hulle het verdien om die wedstrijd te wen. Hulle was die beste span, betere span op die veld te wees. Hulle, die hongerte was meer aan hulle kant as aan ons kant. So hulle verdien die wen. So die season was bietjie lang geweest, baie ontwrigting in die span gehad, maar se verskoning hier, maar baie geluk aan Titus met die wen. Definitief, ons was omtrent seker 7 speel gehelde spelers wat nie vandag gespeel het nie. Van die spelers was by 'n funksie by 'n troue en dan was ook 'n paar beserings. Maar dis nie verskoning hierdie manne wat in hulle plek gespeel het, moes net opgestaan het en was nou nie die geval vir die team ons planeer dit hulle toe hoor nie. Ek dink as ons span het, dit is goed gevaar vandag.
Welcome back, everybody. Yes, hands and hearts. Coach Peter Links there, just giving us the lowdown on their season and how the boys are feeling at the moment. Alistair Frasenberg, we've had him on the show a number of times. Of course, the captain at Hands and Hearts. And as I mentioned earlier on, he will be, he was representing at least with their new scored jerseys at the Sevens, which you'll see a little bit later. He was representing Hands and Hearts at the launch last night. That'll come up in the show a little bit later. Let's catch up now with the captain of Hands and Hearts, Alistair Frasenberg.
I think it was a good game between all three spanners. I think our defense had a bit in the steek gelaat. First time tackles were missed. That had a bit in the ondergang gekry. I can say a good, very good impact. But it had a bit of impact on the spel van ons. Maar ek dink ja, ons het 'n geleentheid gehad om die game te wen. Ons het dit self weggegooi. People's het gekom, het dit gevat met al twee handen. Die punt aan teken en die opponente kom terug en hulle teken weer punt aan, dan denk ek jou ons moet dit begin sak daaroor, maar ek dink weer eens ons defense het ons in die steek gelaat en dat het ons die game gekos.
Alistair Frasenberg, no stranger to Cape Rugby TV. All right, folks, don't forget you can, of course, download the Factory Shops SA mobile app on your mobile phone, and that'll guide you to the nearest factory shop to you. And if you're a store out there and you haven't listed, especially factory shops, if you haven't listed on the Factory Shops SA mobile app yet, get onto the app, download it, and there's a page there that will explain to you how to list. A little bit later in the show, folks, we're going to take a look at the launch of the Western Province Club Rugby Score Sevens Tournament. That starts on the 8th of October. Don't forget, of course, this coming Saturday, the 24th, it is the President's Cup Finals at Newlands. It's going to be very exciting. We hope to see all of you there. As I said, it's a little bit of shows, a little bit different this evening. There's so much action. We're just running through the content. We're going to take an ad break. When we come back, we'll catch up with the final match that was played at City Park, which was, of course, UCT up against SK Warmers. In the top eight, or should we say, the top eight of the Super League A, B, and C leagues. We'll be back after the break. Welcome back, everybody. It's Cape Rugby TV, Wednesday night, as you know. Remember, you can find us on Facebook, www.facebook.com/CapeRugbyTV. Take those photographs, share them on the page, and we put them on the show. All right, of course, as you know, we were at the at City Park over the weekend. The final game at City Park in the top eight. Of course, and for those of you that don't know, these are the bottom eight in Super League A, B, and C is called the top eight, and then the six that played off during the season to make it through into the President's Cup. That's happening this Saturday. First game starts off at half past 12 on Saturday, but we'll look at those fixtures a little bit later. It was SK Warmers up against UCT in the final game at City Park. Let's catch the first half highlights. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Yes, of course, that was a first half for highlights. SK Women's against UCT. As you can see, we're having some snacks between the features here. It's an exciting show tonight, but more excitement for you because there's so much rugby action. As I mentioned earlier on, we will be looking at the Sevens launch. That comes up a little bit later, so don't go anywhere because this is possibly one of the most exciting rugby tournaments that we've had in a long time. In the meantime, let's check out the second half highlights now. UCT against SK Warmers at City Park over the weekend. So a good win there for SK Warmers over UCT, 53-31. A lot more points on the board, I think, that we expected. It certainly looks like the universities are having a little bit of a rough time at the moment. Let's not get into the politics of campus life and how that might impact on the world of sport. Coach Clinton van Rensburg spoke to us after the game.
Yeah, I think the score is obviously not a true reflection. I think our boys stuck to the game quite nicely, and it made a game of it. They were up against a couple of old hands in SK Warmers today, so I'm proud of the boys. I think ill discipline and just being a little bit inexperienced cost us in the day, but the SK Warmers brought their game, that was for sure. It was a relatively young side, very inexperienced, and I think at the end of the day that cost us a bit, but that's why we wanted to blood these boys, so they'll be better for this experience in the future, hopefully in the Varsity Cup 2017.
Well, UCT will of course be getting back into the swing of things pretty soon because of the Varsity Cup. We know that their testing is going to start any day now as they start prepping for the Varsity Cup, which is going to be starting early in 2017. That was Clinton van Rensburg just talking to us on Cape Rugby TV. Daniel Erasmus is the captain at SK Warmers. Let's see what he has to say. Winning captain.
So you can see the wind is a bit gewaai, so it's going to be a wedstrijd wees van twee kanten wat baie sterk kan wees. Well, definitief, in the first half did UCT us a bit vastgevangen in onze half, and that did us a paar punten gekost. But in the tweede half did it weer voor ons gehapen op het einde van die dag. Zoals ik ook gezien had na die game, die geest het baie goed. Kijk, allemaal lid met maar die broederliefde bij die club, maar die jaar was het een beetje anders. Die jaar was het een beetje meer speciaal geweest. So, oefeningen was een beetje tough aan het einde van die jaar, de laatste paar games, naar die einde van die seizoen toe. Maar die ouwens was nog steeds allemaal aan, allemaal committed geweest. Ik denk definitief was het een rust nodig. Maar definitief, het gaan een lange rust geweest. Maar ik denk dat een paar mannen wat zeker zal gaan 7 spelen en zo aan.
SK Women's captain Daniel Erasmus just talking to us there about how things went for them on the day. Now, a guy that's been lighting up the park over the season, Ramiz Osman, he plays fullback at SK Women's. He was the man of the match on Saturday. Let's speak to Ramiz now.
I'm nothing without my teammates, so I can be a man of the match today, but it's a team effort. I can only thank them. Yeah, it was tough, especially with the wind. I think when you played against the wind, keeping ball in hand was key. I think we did that well in the first half, and I think the boys did exceptionally well in the second half with the win. Not yet. We have one more game. It's our annual rag day. So we're playing against Collegians next week. So it will be good. Come down to Greenpoint Track next week, Sunday.
SK Warmers, man of the match there, Ramiz Osman, starring fullback. And that's, as we said, is pretty much of a wrap then for the teams at the bottom eight of Super League A, B and C, except for those teams that are now getting ready for the sevens. Top six will be going into the finals at the President's Cup at Newlands. First game starts at 12:30. While in the south of the field at City Park, we managed to speak to Faisal Felton. He's, of course, the general manager of club rugby at Western Province Rugby.
I think it's a very successful day, as can be seen by the results today. I think it was a great day of rugby. I think for the teams here, nice opportunity to end off the season. I think especially from SK Warmers, guys performed well. From rugby, it was a very good win. And I think it was a very good win. Definitely, I think everybody's looking forward to next week at Newlands, President's Cup. It should be a fun day, good excitement, good rugby on that day. I think definitely looking forward, you know, to club rugby back in Newlands.
Well, Faisal Felton talking to us there about Western Province club rugby and the ins and outs. Okay, folks, as we know now, that's pretty much a wrap then for the clubs in Super League A, B and C in terms of the bottom eight. Top six are now going to be going to the President's Cup. That starts in Newlands, as I've said now many times in the show. Let's look at the results, and some of these are called last week. Stellenbosch against Hamilton's in the Super League A, 52-19. And False Bay then, of course, beating me, or at least not beating me, but going down to Vicks. 29-17, and that's what we called it last week, and we said it was going to be Vicks against Stellenbosch, possibly. You know that False Bay has been playing in the of course been playing in the Gold Cup, so we've got a Stellenbosch Vicks playoff here. And last week, and I spoke to Danny Jones and said who's going to have home ground advantage, and he reminded us that those two teams will be playing at Newlands, so they will be in the finals at the President's Cup at Newlands. All right, the other results then in Super League B, Peniel Villagers, they went down to Hamlets 26-17, and Milnerton, 38-17 win for them over Belleville. All right, so there you have it. Pretty much what Ishmael Dolly was saying was that they will be looking to play a tough match against Hamlets, and that's what it's going to be. It's going to be Milnerton up against Hamlets in the President's Cup this coming Saturday at Newlands. The Super League C results then, Rangers up against Langa, 22-12 win for them. And then Paul beating Franschhoek United 23-15. So our next finals then, it's going to be Rangers up against Paul in the President's Cup. So those are our six games on Saturday. Stellenbosch up against Vicks in the finals in Super League A. It's going to be Hamlets up against Milnerton. And in Super League C, one of the probably the first match is going to be Paul against Rangers. So let's look at the full results then in Super League, in the President's Cup bottom eight finals. Super League A, UCT 31-53 loss against SK Warmers. Hands and Hearts went down to Young Peoples 36-24. And then Super League C, it was a 24-21 win for Aithby against Strand United. Promotions League results. Let's not forget about the Promotions League results here. As we see Vineyards with an 88-31 win over Eersterivier. Silver Tree went down to All Saints, 40 points to 20. Busy Bees, 25-20 over Stelkor. Manenberg Rangers with a 24-15 win over Young Wesleys. Of course, very important then, we understand that the Promotions League is what the top three teams will be going into, is up into Super League C. So it's all to play for still. Let's quickly look at who's top of the log in the Promotions League. Vineyards, Manenberg Rangers, All Saints, Stelkor, Busy Bee, Silvertree, Young Wesleys, Eersterivier and Retreat make up your log there. And of course, the challenge looks like Vineyards, Manenberg Rangers, All Saints, Stelkor and Busy Bees. Those are the guys that are going to be fighting it out to try and get into the top three at least. Meanwhile, in the second round competition results, it was Strand Pioneers who beat went down to Van der Stel 21-13. Peninsula beat Thistles 37-19. And Noordelijkers beating Titans 36 points to 29. Right, folks, as we've been saying, send in your photographs. We'll be capturing them for you. We've got some fantastic pictures that have come in. Our first shot here is once again by Alice Michaels in their, or she was at Rangers. I would have said she was at Elsie's Refere, but or in their match, Elsie's Refere, but it was Rangers against Langa. 22-12 win for them against Langa Rangers, beating Langa there. Nice pick also coming in from Emil Krotz in the Paul versus Franschhoek United game. 23-15 win for Paul. And Gavin Withers posted this picture of the False Bay boys in the False Bay versus Vicks game. Vicks, of course, with a 29-17 victory there. Young Peoples shared the photograph of their victory over Hands and Hearts. A couple of very happy-looking young people boys there. Young Peoples beating Hands and Hearts 34-25. And then Raithby posted the, or at least Dylan Hendricks posted the match, Raithby Universals 24-21. Over Strand United, and a very happy Raithby. Cheslin Colby, folks. Cheslin Colby shared this picture last night at the Western Province Club Rugby Score Sevens launch. Fantastic picture there. It looks like Cheslin Colby himself has got a little photographic touch. Brackenfell Rugby Club posted the another image there. Of course, Verna Cook were the boys from Brackenfell. And those are your social media pictures that came in over the last couple of days. Fantastic to see Cheslin Colby posting the Sevens picture there, so we managed to pick that up. Right, folks, when we come back after the ad break, we'll be doing the Best Med Western Province Rugby Institute insert, and then after that we'll take you to the final insert, which will, of course, be the highlights and launch of the Western Province Rugby Sevens tournament. Welcome back, folks. Cape Rugby TV. Remember, share those pics on Facebook. BestMed has, of course, come on board with the Western Province Rugby School of Excellence. And we managed to speak to one of the players that has come through the ranks and is, of course, playing for the Stormers and the Currie Cup, Daniel Duplessis.
The following Western Province Rugby School of Excellence insert is brought to you by BestMed. Be active, be safe, be happy, be NutriWise, be fin fit.
The first trials I went to was under 18 trials for Craven Week, and yeah, from there it, I'd say, escalated quite quickly. You get there and it's a bunch of guys from different schools and everything, so quite an experience, because it's difficult also, I must say, because trials is almost like you just come in, you throw the ball around and you try just show off your talent, but it's also good to get that exposure. It exposes you to a lot of coaches, and also if you do make the team. My first time going, and a lot of the other guys have joined the School of Excellence a lot earlier at under 16 level. Some of them have even come from under 13 level, and I obviously didn't know what to expect, but I did know a few of the guys, so it was a little bit more comfortable, but it's almost a wake-up call as well when you see the guys benching 130 over there, schoolboys, and also where your training standards are and where you compare to other players in fitness as well.
When you walked in there, were there like Stormers and Province guys? Like, were there any like big names there?
Yeah, I think, I can't remember the first time I walked in there, but a few of the other times you definitely see guys like Sia and Sia Kulisi and Nizam Kaur walking around there, and it's quite like you get, how do I say?
Starstruck.
It's a question I actually get a lot. I was actually asked it the other day. People ask it a lot, how's it playing next to Irvin now when you looked up to Irvin and all of those guys. It's quite weird the first time going on the field, play Cheetahs, make my Stormers debut. Even though you've been training with them for weeks or months, it's still being on the field and just realizing that, like, playing amongst these guys and like your dream has actually become reality is quite cool. Believe in yourself, and if you're not going to believe in yourself, nobody else is. And also just to enjoy yourself while you're playing rugby.
The following Western Province Rugby School of Excellence insert is brought to you by BestMed. Be active, be safe, be happy, be NutriWise, be fin fit.
Daniel Duplessis talking to us about his experiences there at the, his movement through the ranks into the BestMed School of Excellence. Now plays for the Currie Cup and the Stormers sides. Right, folks, as we've been telling you and been getting you ready for, it was the launch of the Western Province Club Rugby Sevens at Tokosan in Newlands on Tuesday night or last night. Very exciting, glitz and glamour. And the guys from Score Energy Drinks, as well as a couple of other sponsors and partners, were out there. And Cape Rugby TV is very proud to be involved in this event, considering the fact that we were involved in the event last year. And it is all starting now on the 8th of October, and you can expect massive entertainment. Anyway, let's take you to some of the highlights. And welcome to the launch of the Western Province Club Rugby Sevens Tournament. We've been talking about this for a while now. My name is JP Nordier. I'm your host and MC this evening. Play Sevens. It is about keeping the club active. If you keep the club active, you've got the community active. If you've got the community active, you've got the fans active. And so it started. We start on the 8th of October. It's going to be 6 weeks of club rugby action at the Goodwood Rugby Football Ground. And of course, this time around, we've got a couple of sponsors involved. So it's going to be very exciting. We put together a little video for you. Do you have what it takes to be a Western Province Club Rugby Sevens legend? To produce the magic game after game with barely a rest in between? To take the hard knocks and keep on going? To represent not only your club, but your community too? Can you match the speed and skill of your opponents with only your own desire to win? It's time for the annual Western Province Club Rugby Sevens, presented by Score Energy Drinks. On the 8th of October, Club Rugby takes centre stage once more at the Western Province Club Rugby Sevens Tournament hosted at the Goodwood Sports Grounds. Together with Score Energy Drinks and Cape Rugby TV, push rugby entertainment to the next level. Now with prize money, unique team jerseys, a kids safe play zone, entertainment and beer gardens, daily best dressed fans and biggest team spirit, this is Western Province Club Rugby at its best. The league season may be over, but the excitement has only just begun. 36 of Province's best seven sides bring you all the steps, all the speed, all the action, all the entertainment. Only the best take to the field, shoulder to shoulder, face to face, for every victory, defeat, for triumph and despair. This is the ultimate six-week challenge of skill, speed and passion. Come and support your local heroes in action as they wear the jersey and represent the communities once again. This is where legends are made. This is the game we love. This is the game we live for. Sevens is where club rugby comes alive. This is heart. This is passion. This is Sevens. This is the Western Province Club Rugby Sevens, presented by Score Energy Drinks. Highlights package that we kind of just snapped together with a limited amount of time. But you got an idea there from what it was like last year. And now Score Energy Drinks is on board, John Stain and the boys. They realized what the bigger picture was. When we started this Sevens tournament, the clubs got to meet other clubs that they never played against before. Super League B players got to meet guys in Super League A. Super League C got to meet guys in... It was a mixed match of opportunity, not only for players, for managers, for administrators. Already tonight when I was just walking around, folks were introducing me to new managers, new coaches who now are getting an opportunity using Sevens to be involved in the world of rugby. I'm sure you all know them, folks. They're the bronze medalists from the Olympics in Rio that recently finished. Werner, congratulations on that gold medal, bronze medal.
Bronze. Oh, we hope it was gold, but no, thanks a lot. It's it was a great achievement for us, and I know we could have done better, but I think we're one of the few people that came home with a medal, so we are very privileged and very happy for it.
Chessie, you didn't get a gold medal, but at least someone in your family got a gold medal.
Yeah, it was the lucky one at the end of the day. But it's better than nothing to bring something back home to South Africa and to represent our country at the Rio Olympics was definitely a privilege for us as South Africans to participate at the Sevens.
Just tell the guys here, from a Western Province rugby point of view, what do you think is the, I mean, when you saw the video now, what was going through your mind in terms of what these guys are going to enjoy on the field?
I think Sevens is all about excitement and guys that want to show a trick or two. So I think there's a lot of talent in club rugby that could go much further than just club rugby. I think the guys are willing to give everything out there coming the 8th of October, and I'm sure the guys will make their certain club teams proud, and I'm sure it will be a great tournament.
Vanna, you've played all around the world. The bridge between Sevens rugby and 15s rugby, and you know, now we're seeing you on the park, and both of you guys are sort of shredding the opposition when you get it. Is it a difficult migration from Sevens into 15?
I think it comes down how you take it. I haven't played 15 rugby in 3.5 years, and when I got on that park, I'm like, yeah, it's a long game. I'm enjoying it so much. It's an amazing game. There is not as much space. You must actually make your own space, but I enjoy it so much.
Does it feel slower to you, like everyone's moving around a little bit slower?
It does, but the hits is bigger, so it makes up for it.
Chazy, for any of the guys that are going to play in the Sevens now, some advice?
Yes, first of all, if you're not going to enjoy yourself, there's no use to participate in this particular sport. So I think it's to go out there, express yourself, enjoy each and every opportunity that you get, and just play for one another. And yeah, I think if you're going to go out there with a smile on your face, you'll definitely do yourself proud and your team is proud.
Werner, Chazy alluded to it just now, the entertainment factor. There's a big difference between 15s and 7s. I mean, you guys have been all around the world, and apart from a lot of funny people who wear things like skull caps and Hulk gloves and a lot of other funny jerseys and things like that, the entertainment factor, the speed of the game, the fact that you've got a game on and it ends and the next game is on, it's all designed really around entertainment.
Yeah, no, it is. Every 20 minutes there's a new game, a new guy that's showing his skill, and that's what makes the game so exciting. There's always something new, and yeah, one funny thing actually, we saw guys in Hong Kong wearing the same outfit for 3 days. So if you can push through that, and just it is all about enjoyment.
The fans, not the players.
The fans, I think probably the fans is enjoying it more than the players, but. No, it's definitely, like Chazy said, if you go on this with a smile on your face on the pitch, yeah, you're going to play the best rugby you've ever played. So.
Classic, guys. We're going to leave it at that. Werner, thanks for joining us here. It's such a privilege to have you guys. Chazy, nice to have you guys back and to see you on the park at Newlands. I see you wearing the Rio 2016 top.
Yes, I just decided to put something on that was blue.
good idea. You know, the last time we spoke was actually at the Sevens last year. What did you think of last year's event?
Yeah, it was something special. I mean, club rugby has a lot of heritage and people underestimate it. That's where we were born as referees as well. So we need to preserve the heritage and make sure that we keep investing into club rugby.
Now, the refereeing structures, I mean, this is also a great opportunity, not only for players to get an opportunity to play, but for referees to get a foot in the door as well.
Yeah, absolutely, because that's where we learn the most. You know, club rugby is more difficult than professional rugby. Professional rugby is the players are skilled and stuff, so we do all our learning at club rugby.
Any advice for the refs when they take to the park? Technical advice? I mean, not that they're here, but we'll put it on television and we'll pass out this advice.
Well, I'll just allude to what Cheslin said. If you don't enjoy it, then there's no point of doing it. You're always going to get adversity in the sport. You'll get criticized left, right and center based on your decision-making skills. But at the end of the day, you know, the game is the winner. It's not the officials or the players. It's about the game, you know. So,
Rasta, we're going to leave it at that. And I must say, none of them have happened without the blessing of the president of Western Province Rugby Football Union. I'm going to call him up now, Mr. Thello Wakefield.
A warm welcome to all of you at the launch of our Western Province Rugby Football Union SCORE Club Rugby Sevens Tournament. We are looking forward to 6 weeks of exciting rugby, 6 weeks of wonderful sort of camaraderie, 6 weeks of enjoyment and 6 weeks of just one hell of a hype and atmosphere at the Goodwood Rugby Football Club. Now, 36 teams confirmed their participation. And I'm sure that the defending champions, the University of Stellenbosch, is looking forward to defend their title again this year. And I know that there will be great competition amongst them as they compete for a total pool prize of close to 100,000 rand. We have selected the venue Goodwood Rugby Football Stadium for a very special reason. It offers a central location with easy access to all participating clubs. Cape Rugby TV, as always. JP, you've become a household name. Thank you for your wonderful function that you perform, taking Western Province Club Rugby into the country. Die verteenwoordiger van SCO het vroeger gesê dit gaan by hulle oor jeug. En dit gaan by ons oor massa-deelname en hoe ons jeug aan die gang kan hou. And then of course, I'm looking forward to spend some time with you at Goodwood Rugby Football Club, away from the boardroom and the general councils and the executive meetings. We're going to forget the meetings and just enjoy the bloody tournament. That's it. Thanks very much.
John Steyn grabbed this opportunity with both hands, got involved with Western Province Rugby, and I'm going to ask John just to come up and say a few words as we introduce you to your headline sponsor for the Western Province Club Rugby Sevens, presented by SCO Energy Drinks.
Our involvement with this tournament. We at SCO, we love rugby. And we also realize the importance of rugby, and especially club rugby, to the communities that are represented here tonight by everybody present. We know that we're living in a society which is not always filled with positive, but club rugby gives this sense of belonging, a sense of pride. It unites communities. We don't need a war to get united. We can use entertainment and fun like club rugby to unite the community. The other main reason for our involvement is the youth of South Africa. Rugby, and club rugby especially, creates an opportunity, like we all know, for youth to get off the streets, play sport, be fit, be healthy. You are role models in the community. You are inspirational to the kids out there.
Starting the 8th of October at Goodwood, there is going to be a beer garden, very importantly. All right, very important. There's going to be a safety zone for the kids to go and play in, for the parents who are, of course, in the beer garden. There's going to be best-dressed fans. There's going to be entertainment, DJs, music. It's going to be fantastic. All right, folks, so hopefully you've got a good idea of the launch of the Western Province Club Rugby SCO Sevens tournament that starts on the 8th of October at the Goodwood Rugby Football Club. It's going to be a lot of excitement. It's going to be very interesting to get out there. I think it's a kind of entertainment we've been looking for quite a while now. Yes, as we know, it's still a couple of games to go, though. So this Saturday, 24th of September, it's going to be the President's Cup at Newlands. Let's take a look at some of the fixtures there. Super League C starts off first. It's Rangers up against Paul, Union Mill against Hamlets, and then Marty's take on Vic. So it's 12:30, 2:15, and 4:00. All happening at Newlands on Saturday. In the Promotions League, meanwhile, it's going to be Busy Bees up against Manenberg Rangers. Esterfield take on Retreat, and Stelcor take on Vineyards, while Young Wesleys are up against Silver Tree. All those matches, by the way, kicking off at 3:30. Caledonian Roses take on Young Ideas in City League in the second round fixtures. Watsonia up against Western Zebras. Police take on Progress, and Perseverance are up against Tech. Meanwhile, of course, in the Northern League, it's Van der Stel against Whistling Wheels, Strand Pioneers and Khayelitsha. Blue Stars take on Atlantis, and Delft are up against Imikawi, also kicking off at 3:30. And then it's the Rag. The Rag is taking place on a Sunday. It's SK Warmers, and they'll be up against Collegians. This is the famous Rag. All right, so adults, 20 Rand, kids under 12, or 5 Rand, pensioners for free if you can produce a SASSA card. But get down there. There's going to be loads of fun. The game started 8:30 in the morning already. So that's the annual rag this 25th of September at the park. So it's SK Warmers up against Collegians. Right, folks, that's a wrap from us at Cape Rugby TV. Hopefully you have a good idea of where we'll where we're at so far for the year, because the league has now come to an end. It's the President's Cup, and then, of course, it's the awards. And then we'll go into the sevens that starts on the 8th of October. That's from a wrap from me. We'll see you again next week. Same time, same place. Have a fantastic rugby weekend. Bye-bye.